It's Katie, and I know you don't have to tell me. You pretended you were a YouTuber, did the whole like, comment, and subscribe spiel, and more than once you've thought of starting a YouTube channel, but for some reason, something stopped you. That was me 5 years ago in middle school, before I became a college student today, with a growing and warm and loving family of 100,000 plus Alohana subscribers. Maybe it's people judging, not knowing how to film or edit, or thinking you don't have enough time to manage a channel. Whatever the case, this YouTube 101 series is for you. This ongoing series I started has everything I wish I knew as a smaller YouTuber starting out trying to navigate the YouTube scene. I've done how I edit my videos, iMovie tips and tricks, how to earn money, how to get more views, copyright-free music YouTubers use, you name it. It's there, and if it's not there, please comment down below any suggestions or video requests you have in the series, and I'd be happy to do it. If you also have any specific questions, I am only a DM on Instagram, Twitter, social media away. All of them are at AlohaKatieX, and by the time you are watching this, I am actually on a very exciting trip. I will be on vacation traveling with my family in Turkey. One last thing before we finally start, I promise you will want to hear this. The special perk of this YouTube 101 series is, drumroll, you can self-promote in the comments. Please do not do this in any of my other videos, and please, for the love of God, do not do sub for sub. No, that does not work, that does not help, that is not genuine. I get it, I know how difficult it can be to grow your channel, and I want to help you, but to do it in an authentic way where your viewers actually care about you and you're actually making friends, introduce yourself, tell people what your channel is about, connect with each other on social media, give each other tips, tricks. I'll link all those down below, but today I'm going to share 5 steps to start a YouTube channel as a student for ultimate beginners. Today we're going to talk about planning, scheduling, and filming equipment. And the next video I want to talk about editing software, uploading videos, how to get more views, and put yourself out there so you're maximizing your time and views. Without further ado, here are the 5 most beginner steps for how you can start your own YouTube channel. Number 1 is planning. Now I break this step down into 2 stages. First is the video outline or the script itself, and the second is an overview of all the videos I will be uploading for a month. For each video, I like to make a script or at least an outline that I can follow for each video so I have a guide for what to say and I ensure I'm actually conveying some message and not being a rambling mess. It also helps a ton when you're editing too, I promise you. For the longest time, I would just turn on my camera, start talking, and I would just go all over the place with what I was saying, and when I was editing, I would have this 1 hour long footage of me just not really saying anything meaningful, so I'd be able to cut it to 8 minutes, but not before wasting, I don't know, 1-2 extra hours just combing through everything I wasn't even gonna use. Especially if you want to manage a YouTube channel as a student still in school, this will save a lot of time, and I promise you creating YouTube videos every week will be manageable. The second thing is a schedule of all the videos I want to upload with the important dates. So that's the target upload date and also the date that I'm going to film the video. As a student, I'm sure you have a planner or some way of keeping organized with all your assignments, so why not do it for YouTube too? To do this, I use Evernote, which is compatible on your laptop, iPad, phone, because they have a calendar template where I can visually convey this. I don't know if I would recommend it though, because the app isn't super friendly, especially for offline editing and syncing. So alternatively, I am trying to shift to Dropbox paper right now, but Google Documents is also a go-to. Pro trick that has helped me save so much time. It's really all about making the most of your time if you want to fit a YouTube channel in your life. What I do every month is bulk film videos. What this means is I do my workflow for a whole month load of videos together. So ideally, I would film 2 to 4 videos in 1 day straight, you know, just change the clothes. Not gonna lie, I don't know about other people, but that's all I do. I just change the shirt so it doesn't look like I didn't try. Even though I just barely tried. And that way, I have all the footage I have already for the next 3 weeks of the month, and I can just focus on each stage on its own, you know, film everything, and then edit everything, and then upload and schedule everything, because I used to do everything on a week basis. So on Saturday, I would film a video, I would edit all the way till Thursday, and then upload on Friday. And if you do that, you know, every week, it's just, you're just, like you're always thrown into that rhythm. This has streamlined my workflow significantly. And to keep track of the progress of all the videos I'm aiming to upload that month, I use a Gantt chart. I learned in CS in high school, actually. I organize it into 6 columns. First one is the video title, and then the next 5 are the 5 stages of each video. So green would mean complete, orange means work in progress, and yellow is like upcoming, keep in mind. Second stage is filming. I'm gonna give some camera suggestions right now. If you're willing to invest in one, by no means is a professional camera necessary for starting one. Look at the quirky YouTubers nowadays, like Emma Chamberlain, Best Dress. They just do inserts in the middle of the video on their webcam with, you know, me editing right now or some photo booth effect, and they have millions of subscribers. So don't let the lack of high quality professional filming equipment stop you from even taking the first step of starting a YouTube channel. I promise you that these things will come later if you see fit. Start with whatever you have, even if you have to borrow your mom's phone. I know some people just borrow their friends' cameras. My first recommendation is the vlog camera that every YouTuber uses. It's the Canon G7X Mark II. I have that myself, but mine's in repair right now. It's high quality, easy to use, and super convenient for vlogging. Second is the Canon T6i, which is what I'm using right now. It's part of the Canon Rebel series, which is actually, in general, just a very popular DSLR line by Canon that a lot of YouTubers use. I'd say from Canon T4i onwards, you are set. The most important thing I learned, though, is that number one, you just need one with a flip screen so you can see what you look like. But remember to look at the lens, because that's why sometimes, you know, I look to the side, because that's where I see myself. But also, second is autofocus. So when you move around and do, like, I don't know, show makeup on screen, it will focus on what you want it to focus on. Along with my camera, I also use a microphone, the Rode Video Micro, because, oh, that was really low, micro. This is not needed because cameras come with built-in microphones. It's just I noticed that sometimes it would be really hot and I would have the aircon. I call it aircon. I know you guys call it AC sometimes. I would turn that thing on and you could hear a lot of background noise, so I thought it would be helpful to get a microphone, but this does not have to be a beginner thing. You can get this later on. But the brand Rode has some of the most popular microphones for DSLRs. Next thing is tripod. My tripod is very simple because I just needed it for the sole use of being stationary, so I could get the right height for my videos and also maybe some tilt action if needed. Important features are quick release, a flexible ball head, and extendable tripod legs. Mine is not a professional video one where you can do pans and tilts. I personally didn't have a need for that, so I didn't get it. I will link mine down below. I think it's relatively cheaper. It's really portable. You'll notice that in general, all tripods are really heavy, but this one I think is relatively lighter. If you're thinking of vlogging more, you might consider a mini tripod, which I would 10 out of 10 recommend, because otherwise you're holding the camera directly in your hands and you're probably gonna be shakier. So I would suggest getting a Joby GorillaPod. It's awesome because you get a better grip and the legs of that tripod are really flexible, so you can wrap it around poles if you wanna, you know, set your tripod up somewhere and then go out and do your intro without having to hold it for an extended period of time. The one I use is the 325 magnetic one, which is good for cameras under 325 grams, and it's magnetic, so it sticks to poles really powerfully. It's great. Again, I will link all of these down below. Another essential is an SD card, at least 32 gigabytes. I would recommend 64. I currently use 128. But also keep in mind, this is my 5th year doing YouTube, and I started out with an 18 gig, and it was so hassle having to constantly delete footage to make space for new ones after every single video I filmed. I use the brand SanDisk, and they have 2 lines, Ultra and Extreme. As you would guess, Extreme is a more advanced line with faster read and write speeds, so transferring files between your camera and your laptop is much better. And it comes in greater memory space, so you can shoot more in higher quality settings, but it is more expensive. Even though I started with the Ultra line, that was 5 years ago, and nowadays the standards have increased so much, you can definitely get a better value SD card at the same price that I bought it for a while back. Last thing, extra batteries. This is unessential. Sometimes you might lose your batteries, sometimes you are out on a long trip or vacation and your battery is gonna die. You need an extra one. Trust me, it is a lifesaver. That's all I'm gonna talk about for this video, but next video, I'm gonna talk about editing software, uploading your videos, how to get more views, design thumbnails, all that, and finally, how to get yourself out there by sharing with people and how to do it effectively. Don't miss out on that video by subscribing down below and turning my notifications on. My vlog channel is here and my main channel is here. Make sure to click the top right eye to watch more videos, especially on that YouTube 101 series. Check it out. A lot of good stuff is already there. Follow me on social media at LohaKDX. Best of luck with your channels. Don't forget to introduce yourself down below. And I will see you next week with another video. Bye!